Juliet Samala, and a big hello for my beloved student. And I hope my students, you all are fine and taking very good care of your precious health. And the chapter which we are going to do it today, that is face showing, and that is from the 7th class, okay, English. And the name of the chapter is face showing. So before we go to the textbook, I would like to explain you the vocabulary, which I have taken from the same chapter. So the first word is masani. Masani is a gift, that a bride gift just after getting married. Okay, in Hindu culture, masani, you know, there is a function which is known as mudikai, or it is a face showing. In that face showing custom, the bride, the wife, you know, the one who got married, she is showing her face after getting a small present or a gift. That gift is known as the masani. And bangles, and every female should know that bangles, you know, this is a kind of ornament which ladies used to put on their wrist, right? And anklets is the pile which we can use on our ankles, right? And the toe ring, the ring here, that is the finger ring. And the same ring if we put on our toe, that is the toe ring, right? Okay, and the bride, the one who is newly got married, you know, especially that time, the bride used for the wife. Lustrous. Lustrous is very shining. Vain, useless. Freckles. Freckles is, you know, a dark spot or any color of spot which we have on our face, that is freckles. And the lame, L-A-M-E, lame. Lame is the person who cannot walk properly, that is lame. And gait, G-A-I-T, gait, the way of walking, okay? And annoyance means to get irritated. If the parents scold every time, your students are annoyed, okay? So that is irritation, to get irritated. Retort means with an anger, okay? And simultaneously means at the same time. Veil, veil is a transparent a scarf which usually, you know, the bride used to cover their face, okay? That is veil. And mumbling is the person who can't speak properly, unusual speaking, right? That is the mumbling. And lavish is okay, lavish is, you know, if some one person is very rich, and we used to say that he is having a luxurious life, lavishly life, we can also say it, okay? And lustrous is the same as lustrous. And pitcher, for pitcher we can say a large pot, an earthen pot, you know, which is having a small opening on the top, that is the pitcher. And grove is the place where we put a group of plants together, that is the grove. And chore is, you know, usually some kind of task that we have to do it, unwilling to do it, but that is compulsion, you know. For example, we have some task in our house, that is household chores, right? Okay, now I'll start explaining the chapter. The day Rahim Bibi came to our village as the newly wedded bride, all the women of our house went to see her. Each took with her something as a masani, as a gift customarily given to see the face of the bride. My mother gave her a pair of bangles, my aunt gave her a pair of anklets, and my elder brother's wife gave her a pair of small silver toe rings. When they returned home, they lavished so much praise on Rahim Bibi's beauty that even we, small children, then were tempted to see her. So, you know, someone who is a bride in this story, that is Rahim Bibi. So she came just after marriage to the village, and you know, and the author family, you know, everybody went to see her, and everybody was, you know, everybody was busy in paying the masani, you know, by looking at their face. Some of them are gifted bangles, and some of them they pay, you know, they gift anklets, pair of anklets. And the brother's wife of this author, they pay the silver toll ring, right? And they, when they return home, they are, you know, like talking very lavishly, you know, in a lavishly manner about the Rahim baby's beauty. You know, how beautiful she is, you know, like small, you know, by listening all this lavishly talk from the senior, junior, you know, the children from the same family, they will also become curious to see her, okay? And my mother said, "What a lovely bride. She looks like a finely chiseled marble statue." The aunt joined in, "What eyes so black and lustrous. Beside, the bride looks fairy tale." Okay, my sister-in-law, who was in a bit wind, said, "Only her complexion is fair, the face is full of freckles. And then how can you know she is sitting? Okay, whether she is lame or hasn't some other defect." Now, everybody, when they back to their home, everybody was talking about the bright beauty, you know. And there is a sister-in-law who was feeling, you know, kind of jealous. And she starts saying, "Only her complexion is clear, fair. Rest, what do you know? She was sitting, she can be a lamp, and she can have another defect in their body." Okay, so it was my mother who replied, "Who says she is lamp? She came out from inside the house, and her gait was perfectly normal." You know, and the mother who replied, the mother of author, she replied, "And who says she is lame? Who said that she can't walk properly? She came out from the inside of the house. Her gait was perfectly normal. I saw that she was coming from the house. You know, she was coming out from the house and she was walking. And I saw her that she is very perfect in walking." Aunt Ed. Aunt, you know, aunt ate something by saying this. "Purple spot on a face, a fair face, ate to the charm." And there was a purple spot on her face that looks more beautiful. You know, that looks more charm to the on her face, right? Okay, now the page number 92. The sentence was completed by my elder brother who had come into the room. "That is Greek beauty for you. The ornament of some royal place. Who are you talking about?" You know, when there were discussion going on inside the house, and there was an elder brother of the author, you know, they came out, they just entered the room, and he was asking, "Who are you talking about?" Mother said, "The washermen have brought the bride home. We were talking about Ilamstein's bride. Okay, we had gone to his place to give Masani. The bride is very beautiful and as far as light." So, telling, you know, explaining to the elder brother that they just came from the Ilamdin's wife, because Ilamdin's wife bride brought room at the home. So, we are just discussion about her beautiness. Okay, my elder brother's wife had extremely beautiful eyes, but her complexion was a bit dark and she was a short. Showing her annoyance, she went inside saying, "After all, she is only a washerman's bride, not a Brahmin or a Rajput bride." That sister-in-law, she was always, you know, felt jealous when somebody prays, you know, about the lady. She said, "That bride is just a wife of a washerman, okay, neither she is a Rajput, neither she belongs to a Rajput or she belongs to a Brahmin family, okay?" And the aunt immediately retorted. Aunt immediately means at the same time. At the same time, retorted means angrily. Angrily replied, "She's no doubt a washerman's bride, but don't people praise beauty even in a lower caste?" Then aunt, you know, auntie got angry and then she said, "Okay, of course she's a washerman's bride, but don't you think that the beautiness, you know, if the family who belongs to a lower caste and that person is very beauty, don't you feel praise, you know, that beauty also?" And they, you know, start arguing. Okay, and the sister-in-law retraced her step and shot back. "Bring her sister for your son then." The reference was obviously to my brother, and yet she had not understood the meaning of Greek beauty. Ilamstein's mother was also our aunt, but to distinguish her from her own aunt, we call her washerwoman aunt. Sometimes when both the aunts would be seated together, we just call auntie. To watch the fun and both responded simultaneously, it made us burst into laughter. Now in this family, you know, when all the cousins are sitting together and there is a, both the aunts are sitting together and the children used to, you know, tease them by calling auntie like that. And, you know, there are two aunties. So both the aunties, you know, respond at the same time, simultaneously, right? So it makes laughter at that on their family. For 3 or 4 days, the new bride was pampered. For 3 or 4 days, everyone who is getting married, you know, for the first week, everybody is resting by not working in their household chores, right? Even this bride also, she was pampered for a few days. But eventually means at the last, finally, she had to join in the household chores. One day, the washerwoman aunt brought her daughter-in-law along with her to fetch water, okay? And one day, for 3 or 4 days, that bride was not working. And finally, that bride also have to join, you know, that household chores. So one day, the washerwoman auntie brought her daughter-in-law along with her to fetch water. To get water, they have to go, you know, somewhere to get the, to fill up the vessel and to bring home. So auntie took her bride to fetch some water, and daughter-in-law had a veil over her face right down the throat. A pitcher rest on her head and a brand new pitcher on it. That means the bride who, you know, which the auntie brought to fetch some water, that bride was covered fully, you know, up to the throat here. Okay, that was covered by with a veil. The veil was near our house. Now, who is talking our house means the author is saying. The well where the people used to get water from the well, that well was near to author house. People from far and near came there to fill their vessel. Okay, people that they are from far or near, they came to their place. That well which is near to their house to get water. Okay, before going to the well, the two women came to our house and the mother-in-law made the daughter-in-law touch the feet of my mother, my aunt, and my sister-in-law. All the three ladies of our house blessed her. May you and your husband live a ripe old age. But after they left, the race under ripple in their house. You know, in Hindu culture, again, the newly got married, you know, the person who are getting newly married, they are getting, you know, they are touching the elder's feet to get the bliss. So the same way, you know, this bride also touched their cousin aunties, you know, and the elder's feet to get the bliss. And they are also blessing like, may you and your husband live till old age. The bride has such a lovely gait like that of the peacock dancing. Now they start again pressing about the bride that, you know, this bride looks very beautiful and the way of walking was very wonderful, you know, like just like a peacock dancing. Mother and aunt were well-meaning women who appreciate others and also condemnation was called for. But my sister-in-law was young and did not like another being praised. Peacocks are dark, but she is so fair. Praising like this, you know, this would amount to saying that a swan is dancing. Cut to the quick, the aunt said, what do we lose if we call a peacock white? This auntie and this author's mother, they like praising other ladies. And this sister-in-law, you know, she can't listen, you know, praising other ladies in front of her because she is a kind of jealous, right? Okay, the sister-in-law kept quiet. Either she could not find a suitable reply or she did not think too expedient to prolong the argument. The following day, the two women came to our house again on their way to the well and sat down for a little chat. Chat means to talk. Ladies have this habit very much rather than the boys. Chatting, gossiping, right? The women of our house inquired from the daughter-in-law about the location of our house in Sarvinsar. This is the place, you know, the name of the place where the women always used to come and just start chatting about others. The mother-in-law advised her, You see, the younger aunt is called Chachi and the elder aunt is called Tai. My son addressed them like that. You should also do likewise. And this is Bhabi, my eldest son's wife. Her husband and Gulabdin went to school together. I call her by her first name. You should always, address her Bhabi. This mother-in-law, advising her that the elder mommy is known as Chachi, and no, the younger aunt is known as the Chachi, and the elder one known as the Tai. Okay, and she was addressing her to call her Bhabi. And after a few days, mother-in-law stopped coming with her daughter-in-law. Probably, she was engaged in another domestic chores at home. Rahim baby came to the well twice in the morning and in the evening. Going to school in the morning, we would see her on the way. One day, while the other two boys had gone ahead, I remained behind, and when I saw her coming from the opposite direction, she had her face covered as usual, right down the throat. A little hesitantly, I said, "Rahim baby, you can show your face to me. I'm so small." Now the author is telling us, one day he was coming from the school. He saw the bride was coming to fetch some water, because auntie is not coming this day, because auntie, before, auntie was busy in domestic chores. Okay, so the bride, after a few days, bride start walking to get water from the well. Okay, so on their way, the author met that bride, and author, he was a small child. He asked that Bhabi, Rahim baby, to show the face. And Rahim baby kept walking and said, kept walking means keep continue walking. And she said, "Bauji, if you want to see my face, you will have to give me masani. Okay, you have to gift me, you have to present me my masani if you want to see my face." We were walking in different direction, and before I could give any reply, she had gone some distance. Now, both of them, they are walking, and after some time, the Rahim Bibi left. So, there is much distance, so they cannot talk for a long time. Okay, and the next day, I managed to remain behind again, and as I crossed her path, I said, "Rahim Bibi, what would you like to have as a masani? I shall get it for you from my mother." Okay, the next day, I managed to remain behind again. Next day again, they met, and a second time also, this author asked her, that Rahim Bibi, that what would you like to have as a masani? I will give you, I'll take the money from my mother and I'll buy it for you. And then Rahim Bibi replied, no, not from Chachi. I shall show you my face only when you give masani out of your own earning. Until then, I will not lift my veil. Okay, if you get my masani from your own salary, then I will show you my face by lifting the veil. Okay, otherwise don't take money from your chachi. Okay, Rahim Bibi stuck to what she said. For years she kept her veil. For years means salon tak. She kept her veil means she kept continuing, covering her face. In the next 3 years, I did my 8th class and went to Jammu for further schooling. From Jammu, I went to Srinagar and could not go to the village for another year and a half. I was now 15 and had failed in the 9th class. Okay. And I went home during the vacation and met Rahim Bibi. She asked, "Bauji, in what class are you studying now?" Okay, now, so that bride did not show her face to the author, okay? And in the meantime, he was, for the next 3 years, till then he did his class 8 and went to Jammu and then Srinagar for a schooling. And then he was failed in the 9th class, okay? And went home again during the vacation, during the holidays, when they have a holiday, they went home during vacation and met Rahim Bibi. She asked, "Bauji, in which class are you studying now?" They are talking to each other, like, "In which class you are?" He said, "Ninth. Last year also you were in ninth." You know, last year you were also in 9th, this time also you are in 9th, you know, they are start in talking. And, you know, as he was failed, as the author was failed in 9th class, so he start, you know, mumbling. He cannot speak properly because of that insult. He was feeling very shy, very insult. So, okay. So here I'm going to stop the first session. I won't make you much bore. And if you have, till here, if you have any kind of questions from the face showing, please contact me on my number. It's on your screen. Thukje Che Jule.